And they say, oh, you're just like your father. But, you know, 2 or 3 minutes ago, you hugged me. And you said to me, oh, mommy love you. You know, mommy love you real bad. But after telling me you love me, then you are going to, you're going to compare me to the man that I hear you cursing this morning, saying he's the worst thing on earth, and I'm sorry you didn't walk on that bus, or what was I doing when I thought of being with him, and so on. Are you not confusing that, child? How can you tell me you love me when you're comparing me to the person that I can tell by your language and so on, that this is the person you hear most in the world? So as parents, we need to be very careful of the message that we are sending to our children. And they're listening. They have impressionable minds, as we said earlier, and sometimes we don't know, we don't think that they're observing, but they're observing and they're learning. Even if it is learning the wrong thing, they are learning. Yes. Now, for your second question, as it pertains to counseling, yes, there is counseling across the board for all parties involved in bullying, whether it be the person exhibiting the bullying behavior, whether it be the target, whether it be the bystander. But one of the things that we also want teachers to get out of the habit of doing. Shawn, come here. Donna reported to me that you have been bullying Mary. That's a no-no. Because what you're doing is that you are not putting the focus on Donna, you're exposing Donna and possibly to become the next target. Yes. So there's a way of doing that. It has been reported to me. Or a teacher realized that this is happening or whatever. We have reason to believe that, in opposed to identifying any one individual.
But if you don't substantiate it, then can it not be just allow open season for a teacher who may have it in for Willie because his dad is a bank manager, and I'm like, ah, good. I'm going to say Willie is a bully. I'm going to fix it. Now the teacher's a bully.
Yes.
By using your avoiding of who is the bystander. In other words, who watches the watchman?
I think we really need as a society to look at some persons and you know, that we have in our teaching system. And I'm not here to cry on teachers and say, because teachers do a fantastic job every single day. They're responsible for a lot of positive things that happen within the society. But there's a situation where teachers bully as well. Students report it to us. The reality is, if you stand in front of a classroom and you say something to a child in front of 29 or 30 of his peers, something extremely negative, and then when that child answers you back, especially to save face, then you're going to bully that child in terms of the imbalance of power or strength, or go to the principal, go to the door. You can't talk to me like that in my classroom. So teachers and adults need to take responsibility and need to realize that we have the power in our hands, really, to remedy this thing, or to have it, you know, the continuation of it. We have the power in our hands to get it right. If it means that we need to get rid of some bad apples, there are bad apples in all systems. If it means that that is what we need to do to protect our children, then we need to do it. It is a relatively expensive program, I think, the program in its entirety. However, it is not as expensive as the money that Barbados will have to house some 10 or 15 years from now if we have to spend it on our penal system, if we have to spend it on health care. So the money that we invest in it at this stage is very, very relevant. It is vital, it is important, and it saves us in the long run. I know you're probably looking for dollars and cents, but all I'm going to say to you as it pertains to dollars and cents is that it is a wise investment. It is an investment that can help Barbados.
$10,000, $20,000.
I am not willing at this stage, sir, to put a cap on it. I'm gonna, because I don't think we can put a $5, a $10, or a $20 cap on eradicating bullying from the society. It is a cost that is well spent.
Before you go any further, I want to add to that, V-A-L-U-E spells value. And that's the most important thing here. We tend to see value as dollars and cents, but the outcomes that we're looking for are achievable, but they're not achievable unless we have your investment. And we can't ask you for money to invest in this. We're asking you for your value, and that's what we're going to get out of
this. This system has been implemented at the 4 schools, which launched recently the Olweus Bullying Prevention Program. and they are the Frederick Smith, Lester Vaughan, Grantley Adams, and the Wesley Hall Infant Schools. The Spriggio program, the Spriggio reporting system, it provides the school with reliable data, record keeping, and indicators, trend indicators for minimalizing bullying. So a student, if a student is being bullied, or if they know of incidences of bullying, they can report, they can access the online form using the Spriggio reporting system, and they can record those incidences in a safe environment where they don't have to feel the fear of reprisal from other students, you know, because they may think that the students might come to them and say, oh, you know, you were you went and you reported this incident of bullying, and I am going to get back at you. This system is a confidential system. It's password protected, and it's only accessible by the administrators in the school who have been fully trained to access the system. Now, the key indicators of this system are that no two schools can view each other's data, but all the data can be seen by Mr. Clarke at his office at the Supreme Counselling for Personal Development's office. Unlike Facebook, text messaging, broadcast, BlackBerry broadcast messaging, which can reach all the students in a school, Spriggio is only viewable by the administrator. So, as I said, a student making a report does not have to fear reprisal. The reports remain logged in a password-protected online dashboard, and it's only accessible by the trained administrators. One of the key impact of this system is that, together with Supreme Counselling for Personal Development, we feel that this new software can report all incidences of bullying. Students are confident knowing that their identities are protected, and I want to stress that all reported incidences of bullying using this system will be investigated.
We have a problem in Barbados that needs to be addressed. I see it daily in my office at Supreme Counselling for Personal Development, where we go to the schools, we see it, and unfortunately, it is now reported in the public, in the public domain. We are not getting an idea as to what is really happening. That is not to say that bullying is something new. Bullying has been going on from the time of memorial. You had one school back in the day calling it the initiation. There have always been all kinds of names given to bullying, and it was seen as a rite of passage. It was to teach me to be a man. So every day I receive a slap around my head as soon as I enter school, or some person takes my money whenever I enter the canteen. That was not taking advantage of me. That was not bullying me. That was teaching me to be a man, to toughen up. The reality, ladies and gentlemen, is that bullying is peer abuse, and it must be treated in that way. We will not say to victims of domestic violence or child abuse to toughen up, to not let it get to you, to deal with it on your own. We ran to the child care board, we involved the police. We must see bullying for exactly what it is, and that is peer abuse. It is peer abuse, which means as well that adults are responsible. If we are supposed to deal with it, if we are supposed to bring an end to it, then adults need to be responsible. It's a learned behavior. And if it's a learned behavior, it means that the children obviously is learning this behavior from somewhere. We have started the program. We have had the kickoff events. Each of the four schools now have their bullying prevention coordinating committees in place. And the committees are responsible for administering the program at the school level. Although it's a program for Barbados, we realize that different schools have their own cultures. So it means that whatever is put in place to govern bullying, it must be done at the school level. And the bullying prevention coordinating committees, they are working, they are putting in place the positive reinforcement systems, they are putting in place systems to deal with negative behaviors, they are having their class meetings where the children are being informed what is bullying, what constitutes bullying, what to do if you are being bullied, what are the signs and symptoms of persons exhibiting bullying behaviors or targets of bullying. So we have started to work. and it is happening. I can give you an example of the Grantley Adams Memorial Secondary School, and I can say this openly and freely because the principal has given permission. He is very happy that the program is already working at his school. He reported to us an incident where four of his male students were all playing, they were having fun, there's a game at Grantley Adams School called Slap Head. They were playing and slapping up each other and so on. One guy decided, okay, I really had enough of this. It is time to stop. But one guy continued the action. And the other two guys said, you hear the man say stop, you need to stop. That is bullying. If he says stop, then you should stop. And I think what warmed the principal's heart is prior to the launch of the program, he said, those two young men would have joined in the activity and they would have continued, which means that the bystander effect is taking, it is beginning to work at the school level. And that is really something that we need to put out there, that our children are buying into the program, that things are happening. This program has been endorsed by the Ministry of Education. I have met with officials there. They are on board with the Olweus Bullying Prevention Program. We are training not only the teachers from the four schools where we are piloting the project, but we are also working with teachers at other schools as well. We need to get the message out there that bullying is wrong, that bullying is bad, that bullying is taking advantage, as was said in the definition, of persons who are unable or who are perceived to be unable to defend themselves. It means that we have to be the defenders. We have to work with them. It is not a job that Supreme Counselling can do alone. It is not a job that the Ministry of Education can do alone. It is not a job that the Maria Holder Memorial Trust can do alone. It has to be a holistic approach. And that is why I am not in support of any zero tolerance policy as it relates to bullying. Zero tolerance policies in Barbados, if I can be extremely frank, very short life. It's zero tolerance for 2-3 weeks, and then at the end of it, that is that. If you're going to say to me that you have a zero tolerance policy with intervention, then I can start to drift to your side. It makes no sense at all in sending children home, for example, for bullying without some kind of intervention, because they're only going to return to school and repeat the same action because you have not given them tools to work with. There's no different way of doing it, so they will continue doing it the way that they're doing it. What we need to do is to have a holistic approach to solving bullying, where parents have to be heavily involved in helping us to deal with this thing called bullying. I am very passionate about it because I think it has already destroyed lives of young people in Barbados. It have already destroyed it. Sometimes when you speak to older persons in our society, very seldom they say to you, you know, I remember back in 1950 when Shawn beat me real bad at school. They always say to you, or more often than not, I remember when my grandmother said this to me. Or I remember when the next door neighbor said that to me. I'm saying that to say that words have damaging effects and long-lasting effects on the life of persons. So that it is not only the physical. We cannot only look at, you know, the boy hitting another boy on the top of his head with an object. We cannot just look at this. We have to look at words, verbal abuse, and the kind of psychological impact, the kind of psychological effect that those words can have on our young people, probably not today or tomorrow, but when they reach adulthood. And reports from Olweus in a survey carried out says that persons who exhibit bullying behaviors in their young years, by the time they reach age 23, they have at least 4 or more criminal convictions.
We can't do it without you. We are pushing and pressing and we're going to go past the walls that are before us. We're going to go past the challenges that we've encountered already. And we want to say to you, Corporate Barbados, come on board. We need your help because we are committed to stop the bullying. Now, there's so much that has to be done. and we've only just started. And as Shawn's saying, I have to keep referring to you. This is not a now thing. We are thinking about the future of Barbados. And so we're going to start with the youth. We've already engaged many of them at the various schools, and we've seen results already. We're starting with the youth for today, but we want to continue and make sure our future is conducive to a happy place. Now, there's much to be done, as I said, and if we get the corporate Barbados on board, we have to recognize that adults, we have a responsibility. You parents, you have to create the environment in your home that is conducive to respect. With respect, there will be no bullying. With love, there will be no or little bullying. And we want you to embrace this. Embrace the notion, the importance of stop allowing this bullying to happen. I'm sorry, I have to press. It starts in our homes. Okay? It filters into the schools. Then it's in the classroom. It's on the street, in the communities, and by extension, in the workplace.
There needs to be some legislation in place so that principals, for example, will be on the same page, that teachers will be on the same page. They know what needs to be done. There's something to fall back on. I think one of the problems we have, because there's no legislation, there's nothing governing bullying at this stage in terms of legislation. Principal of school A will deal with a matter one way, principal at school B will deal with a similar matter another way. We need some kind of uniformity. In addition to all of that, it is also very important, I mentioned this somewhere else this morning, I will mention it here as well. In Pennsylvania, a parent took a school district to court because she believed that the school, there was somewhat delinquent in addressing a case of bullying there, and she was awarded $2.5 million. She could have received $5 million, but what saved her is when the magistrate asked, is there a program in place at the school, is there a mechanism at the school to deal with and address bullying, they were able to say, yes, we have implemented and we are working with the Olweus bullying prevention program. We will sit and say, oh, that can't happen here, that will never happen here. But as my grandmother always said, God bless her in her grave, we meet a man in Basi. So anything is very possible.